brilliant.
Simon and Garfunkel, Cecilia, why is it your trigger tune?
Well, Rob? Trigger tunes are a song that transports you back to an embarrassing moment.
Yeah.
Set the scene, year six of school at the disco, and there was a girl there I fancied, and when the chorus come in, I'm down on my knees, I'm begging you please. I went on my knees and begged for a dance, like a hungry dog.
And what happened? Did she dance with
you? No, she didn't dance with me. And, and I was on my knees begging, and everyone just was like, what is he doing? Then everyone told my mum, and then she was angry with me. And it was awful. And then whenever I hear that song now, I feel like I'm getting hot. I'm talking quick.
Do you want me to turn it down?
Please, can you turn that song off?
Sorry.
I'm going to go home now, actually, and think about that all day.
Do you remember her name?
No, I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Sue, give my hug.
Sue, hug me. Hug me, Sue.
Nothing like a Sue Barker hug. Richie's got your travel.
Thank you so much. We're going to start in Lincolnshire on the High Street, the A1077. This is Barton up on Humber. Closed at the moment because of an accident at South Ferriby. The M62. Eastbound, one lane out between 10 and 11 for Birchwood. That's because of a breakdown. Lisa's been on to say, Richard, what's going on in Northampton, Danes Camp Way? So this is the A5076. It's closed at the moment because of an overturned lorry. So there's been a spillage. So it's between Hunsbury Hill Road. But the queues are back to Toaster Road and they're spilling into Northampton as well as traffic diverts away. In Conwy, the North Wales Expressway, the A55, there's a rolling roadblock and rubbish on the road at the moment on Conwy Road with the closure back to junction 18. That's a Llandudno junction. The M11 southbound, long delays at the moment between 11 for Cambridge and 13. That's because of an accident. And finally, Zoe, M25 anti-clockwise, a lane out on the exit slip road at 8 for Reigate. That's because of a broken down car, and you're up to date.
Thank you very much. If I play that for you now, you all right there?
I'm ready.
Oh, look, he's ready for it tomorrow. Oh, he's gonna be amazing. Rob, you were in The Lion King.
Yes, with Ramesh, I played a wildebeest. Oh. The back end of a wildebeest, literally, it's not a joke.
It's beautiful.
I shuffled on, shuffled off. It's on Sky Max.
Can I say, so much love coming in for our guests today. We've absolutely loved having you all. Rob's book, Parenting Hell, is out next Thursday, 13th of October. The 2023 Arena Tour, Parenting Hell Live with Josh Widdicombe. Tickets are on sale now. And Unbreakable continues on BBC One next Thursday. You can catch up on the first episode on the iPlayer. Do they all stay together at the end?
No comment.
Wait and see. I hope Shirley's all right. Yeah. Sue Barker, it's been glorious to speak to you. Oh. Calling the shots. The book is out now, and tickets are on sale for you're doing a live tour.
Yes.
Calling the shots.
I'm
how
on tour.
Fabulous.
I never thought I'd be on tour.
Oh, wonderful. Yes, what's going to be on your rider, Sue? Do you reckon?
I have a glass of Sauvignon Blanc. That's it.
Lovely. Oh, that's all she needs.
Yes.
And Ollie's brand new single, "Dive a Broken Heart," is out now.
Yes.
Ollie, new album, "Marry Me," is out on the 2nd of December and available to pre-order. And tickets go on sale for his tour on Friday the 14th of October. Woo. You have been fabulous, guys. Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Amazing.
Rob Beckett.
Until next
time.
This
is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 9 o'clock. This is Tina DeHealy. There's a warning that without a complete restructure of the social care system, many people will be left without support. Care England, which represents independent providers, says a proper vision is needed or the NHS will be on its knees. The government has set out a plan for reforming adult social care in England with £5.4 billion of funding over the next 3 years. But Wendy Hughes, who's a care and support worker at Dementia Matters in Newcastle, says the system needs fixing.
Where's you out? Are we going to end up where we've got a system where nobody's going to be able to recruit anybody? I know lots of people that's left the system. You can go stack shelves and get paid more than I get paid. We have a crisis, big crisis.
President Biden has suggested that the risk of nuclear war is at its highest level since the Cuban Missile Crisis 60 years ago. He said that Vladimir Putin was not joking when hinting that Russia could use weapons of mass destruction in Ukraine. Journalists overheard Mr. Biden's comments at a Democratic Party fundraising event in New York. Here's our North America correspondent Peter Bowes.
US officials have been warning for several months that Russia could resort to the use of weapons of mass destruction if it suffered setbacks on the battlefield in Ukraine. Mr. Biden told fellow Democrats the use of tactical, nuclear, biological or chemical weapons could quickly spiral out of control into global destruction. Last week, the US National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan said despite Mr. Putin's saber-rattling, the US had seen no signs that Russia was imminently preparing to use nuclear weapons.
Ministers have launched a new licensing round for oil and gas exploration in the North Sea. The Business Secretary, Jacob Rees-Mogg, says that exploiting reserves will strengthen Britain's energy security. But climate scientists have previously warned that new fossil fuel projects go against efforts to minimise global temperature rises. Scotland's First Minister, Nicola Sturgeon, says there has to be a careful, planned transition from fossil fuels to renewable energy.
My objection to the UK government's approach is the sort of haphazard approach to it, which is undermining energy security. The route to energy security is renewable energy. They're undermining that, in my view, rather than supporting it.
The Department for Transport has told the train operator of Avanti West Coast to drastically improve its services after giving it a six-month extension to its contract. Avanti faced widespread criticism for cutting the number of trains between Manchester and London by a third in August because of driver shortages. A statue of the first black footballer to be selected for England is being unveiled today at Plymouth Argyle Stadium. Jack Leslie scored more than 130 goals for the club and was called up by the national side almost a century ago. But campaigners say he was dropped from the England squad because of his colour. The weather, a band of heavy rain will move southwards through England and Wales during the day. Sunshine and showers across Scotland and Northern Ireland. That's the BBC News at 3 minutes past nine.
BBC Radio 2. The Zoe Ball
Breakfast Show. Can we do a podcast now, maybe, and have all the conversations I've just had with Rob and Sue and Ollie?
We should,
off the air. Have you got another hour?
Yeah, we'll record it now. What should we call it?
Okay, I've got to do Pick Your Own Playlist time. At 9 o'clock, you take control of the airwaves. Andy and Sharon King in Leeds are on the decks today. They pick these tracks whilst on their way back from a festival in Henley-on-Thames, celebrating the wedding anniversary. They've dedicated these to you lovely listeners who've been working hard all week, and I hope that they'll lift you up. Let's see, they've done a very, very good job. Some funky tunes for you on a Friday. Thanks for being terrific guests, by the way.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Zoe.
Loved it. It's been a blast.
The things I've learnt today. Oh!